After 7 minutes of terror, the Mars Curiosity rover finally touched down on the Martian surface and began what's probably going to be known as the most sophisticated and ambitious search for life on another planetary body. But what are we searching for? Just what are we looking for? Can we define life? Well, we can certainly come up with a list of characteristics for life. We can say that life reproduces, it grows, it takes in energy, much like a chemist might try to define water before knowledge of the periodic table. But a list of characteristics is not a concise or meaningful definition. So just what is life? Any child can tell you the difference between a beloved toy and a rabbit outside in the backyard. What is music? Is music the notes on a page? Is it the vibrations in the air? Is it the sound that we hear? Is music an orchestra, a CD? And when is music music? Is it a full piece? Is it a recognizable phrase? Or is music the very first inkling of noise that hits your ear? Similarly, is there a minimum set of these characteristics of life so that constitutes a living system? What precisely was it that happened the moment the velveteen rabbit became a living creature? Can we recognize that, and can we find it? Well, logic would tell us that if we don't know what we're looking for, we're not going to have very much success. So is curiosity on a fool's errand? Well, I would argue that it's not. We know that life as we know it exists within a well-defined set of physical parameters, not too hot, not too cold. Curiosity has successfully defined the first habitable environment beyond Earth. We can recognize these systems that are consistent with living systems, consistent with life. That list of characteristics? Well, those are dynamic processes. Those dynamic processes interact with the environment and they leave traces. A stuffed animal is never going to need to be cleaned up after, but the metabolism of a pet rabbit is going to leave irrefutable evidence that it's of its existence, necessitating regular cage cleanup. Similarly, we can look for these biosignatures, and we can pursue hypothesis-driven scientific questions. For instance, do these biosignatures exist within a habitable environment, while pondering the philosophical questions such as the definition of life, reminding us that in science it may happen that the most interesting questions to pursue are ones that may well be, at the time being, cannot be answered.
All right.